Somewhere around 20,000 years ago, Northern Europe was covered by ice. There was no Baltic Sea or English Channel. Most part of Western Europe was bound by ice. However, it was a bit different in Eastern Europe. If Karelia and Valda were sheer white spot, further east the glacier's edge ceded. Middle Urals and Povols he were practically suitable for life. Asian and Russian steppes were inhabited by rhinos, camels, saber-toothed cats, ostriches, lions, bisons and mammoths. Did the sun switch off for France, while it was switched on for Russia? In Alaska, thick frozen deposits of soil, boulder, plant and animal exist, commonly known as muck. Alaskan muck is like a fine, dark gray sand. Throughout the Alaskan mucks there is evidence of atmospheric disturbances of unparalleled violence. Mammoth and bison alike were torn and twisted as though by a cosmic hand and godly rage. In many places, Alaskan muck is packed with animal bones and debris and trainload lots. Bones of mammoths, mastodons, several kind of bison, horses, wolves, bears and lions tell a story of a faunal population. Within this frozen mass lie the twisted parts of animals and trees intermingled with lenses of ice and layers of peat and mosses. It looks as though in the midst of some cataclysmic catastrophe of 10,000 years ago, the whole Alaskan world of living animals and plants was suddenly frozen in mid-motion like a grim charade. Twisted and torn trees are piled in splintered masses. In one place, we can find the foreleg and shoulder of a mammoth with portions of the flesh and the toenails, the hair still clinging to the blackened bones. Close by is the neck and skull of a bison with the vertebrae clinging together with tendons and ligaments and the chitinous covering of the horns intact. There is no mark of a knife or cutting instrument. The animals were simply torn apart and scattered over the landscape like things of straw and string, even though some of them weighed several tons. Tens of thousands of skeletons and individual bones of many kinds of animals have been discovered in the permafrost. This means that hundreds of thousands of individuals, not merely a couple dozen or so, must have been frozen immediately after death, and remained frozen. Mixed with the piles of bones are trees, also twisted and torn and piled in tangled groups. And the whole is covered with fine sifting muck, then frozen solid. These vast herds of animals that were peacefully grazing in then temporal zones, were washed away by an unprecedented tidal wave carrying mud, trash and debris ahead of it, then quickly ended in the Arctic regions along with their fields, and froze. Interesting fact. Heavy deposits of volcanic dust are associated with these finds. Interspersed in the muck and sometimes through the very piles of bones and tusks, are layers of volcanic ash. There is no doubt that coincidental with the end of the Pleistocene animals there were volcanic eruptions of tremendous proportions. Series of disastrous volcanic eruptions was corollary with the beginning of the Ice Age on Earth, according to recent study by Stephen Carter of New Mexico Institute of Mining and Technology. At least four considerable layers of volcanic ash may be traced in these deposits, although they are extremely warped and distorted. This suggests that although volcanoes were erupting, other forces were required to dismember these animals, with mighty floods and hurricanes being the most likely. Arctic Ocean was warm and luxuriant forests were growing along the Arctic coasts in the past. The evidence for the warm Arctic is overwhelming. Greenland is the contemporary example of what, according to the ice age theory, happened to a large part of the world in times past. The island is largely within the Arctic Circle. Over 700,000 square miles of its surface are covered with an immense mountain of ice that leaves free only the coastal fringes. The ice age survived in Greenland. And what is no less surprising, the northern part of Greenland, according to the concerted opinion of glaciologists, was never glaciated. Probably, then as well as now, an exception was the northernmost part of Greenland, for it seems a rule that the most northerly lands were never glaciated. It is a remarkable fact that the islands of Arctic Archipelago were never glaciated. No ice mass ever covered the lowlands of northern Siberia, any more than the interior of Alaska. If this is the case with Siberia, what are we to think when we contemplate the new Siberian islands? There, Baron von Toll found remains of a saber-toothed cat, Smilodon, and a fruit tree 27 meters tall. The tree was very perfectly preserved in the permafrost, with its roots and seeds. Green leaves and ripe fruit still clung to its branches. Yet, at the present time, the only tree vegetation on the islands is a willow that grows 1 inch high. Spitsbergen is an island in the Arctic Ocean, 11 degrees from the North Pole, to the north of Norway. Here identified 136 species of fossil plants from Spitsbergen. Among these were pines, firs, spruces, cypresses, also elms, hazels, and water lilies. At the northernmost tip of Spitsbergen Archipelago, a bed of black and lustrous coal 25 to 30 feet thick was found. There must have been great forests on Spitsbergen to produce a bed of coal 30 feet thick. Spitsbergen is buried in darkness for half the year, and is now almost continuously buried under snow and ice. And even if Spitsbergen, almost 1,000 miles inside the Arctic Circle, for some unknown reason had the warm climate of the French Riviera on the Mediterranean, still these thick forests could not have grown there, because the place is 6 months in continuous night. The rest of the year the sun stands low over the horizon. Not only fossil trees and coal, but corals, too, were found there. Corals grow only in tropical water. In the Mediterranean, in the climate of Egypt or Morocco, it is too cold for them. But they grew in Spitsbergen. At some time in the remote past corals grew, and their fossils are still found, on the entire fringe of polar North America, in Alaska, Canada, and Greenland. In later times, fig palms bloomed within the Arctic Circle. Remains of magnolias are found in Greenland. Forests of giant sequoia grew from Bering Strait to north of Labrador. It is difficult to imagine any possible conditions of climate in which these plants could grow so near to the pole, deprived of sunlight for many months of the year. In one of the coal mines of Atyn Basin, Russia, near the Arctic Circle, imprints of plants were found, algae, mosses, equisetacea, skeletons of extinct fish, remains of amphibians. One of them, Labyrinthodon, was previously found only in far more southerly latitudes. Since plants and animals that lived in tropical climate are found near the Arctic Circle, scientists concluded that climate of these regions was not severe in Paleozoic era. At both ends of the globe, places which are currently the coldest on Earth, we find evidence of warmth, equivalent to that of latitudes at least 30 degrees closer to the equator.